Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, this is Oskar coming to you with yet another episode in my series Let's Play Life is Futile Your Own. People, it was and is a kinda disastrous day. First, I've gotten off into the game. I went on, just wanted to check some of my stuff, what is going on and so on. While having my morning coffee, I looked into my stable and I saw, don't look over there, I saw this annoying, really bad message. All of my animals died during the last night. They kinda may have drowned in their own poo. Well, I've actually, before I locked off last night, I checked my stable and the coops and so on. Everything was fine and dandy. I cleaned them up, and about 8 hours later, when I checked again, the dung-o-meter was at 158% and all the animals were dead. Made me really sad. Problem with this is most likely that the server setting on the server I'm playing right now has a increased day and night cycle, so the days are shorter, nights as well, which makes the animals poo a little more. So yeah, I need to look into this in the long run, how I can handle this. I won't be able to breed that much bulls or cows, because I can't keep them in my inventory, at least not that much. They are kind of heavy. Let me just check real quick. If I take one bull in my inventory, they weigh 120 stones. So when I'm complete naked and don't have anything else in my inventory, I would be able to hold 3 animals, which is then the maximum amount of animals I would be able to breed. So, kinda sucks. Well, need to look into this. Then after I ventured out and tamed 2 new bulls for my stable, I started recording the premised episode about farming, harvesting flax, processing all this stuff, showing how to build a well and so on and so forth. I recorded, I edited all the stuff, and what happened? I accidentally deleted the complete episode which was ready to upload. Well, so now I have to wait again till the next batch of flax is grown up. It will be one of those fields here. Then I actually had planned, or had said, that I wanted to show you how I complete the well over here. Well, this is on the recorded and lost footage. So, yeah, you kinda missed that one, but that's not that overly bad. Well, here you see the well as it's done. You pretty much know how the crafting and construction windows and so on look by now. I already shown up how, what is needed for the thingy: 60 rocks, 5 ports, if I, no, 5 metal bands, 10 ropes and something, I have forgotten, some boards, 15 boards I think. They are all added, standing on 100% quality soil. So now if I get some water out of this well, it is always at quality 100. I have already used this thingy a few times, and the durability should still be fine and dandy. It's only that you can guess this, do the math with the quality. The highest durability a building or device can have is 20,000. This has 10k.4 durability, so it will be a bit more than 50 quality abouts. Which is perfectly fine, since I'm the only reason I need more durability is would be if there wasn't a monument. But since this well is standing on a claim, it won't decay, it won't get used up by getting water out of it, and the quality of the water is only determined by the soil quality it is built on. So everything fine and dandy. So what do we do now? I'm actually not going to wait to show you how I harvest this flux. I hope that I have some flux sitting around somewhere in a box here. Yeah. Okay, this is how flux looks when you harvest it. Harvest the stuff. These are the seeds. They come always in the same amount. The yield of each field is determined by the weather during the growing periods. I was really lucky. All my fields were in between 8 and 12 units in yield, which is the cap. You can't get any more. So I've got quite a lot of really good quality flux out of this. This was all around 90s. I think 89 was the lowest, the highest was 97. I hope this is still some flax in this tanning tubs here. This is what you do next with your flax. You grab 3 units of water and 10 flax stems, put them into a tanning tub, wait for 1 hour, then go to the pickup option, and what you get is this thingy here, flax fibers. It's always double the amount of the flax you inserted, so 20 always. After you got the fibers out, I'm just showcasing this on this one batch of fiber to make this a bit short. My other episode was a bit long anyways. Then after that you need a spinning wheel built by carpenters. It should be in higher quality, so to say. This one I think is pretty low, because the metal components from me are rather bad and I wanted to make some. Oh, it's actually quite good. Should be somewhere almost 15k durability, means it should have a quality from 75-ish. So, however, you go to the spinning wheel with your flex fibers in the inventory, go to procuration. Sorry for that. Use the spinning wheel. The crafting window opens up with the stuff you can actually make, or could make on a spinning wheel. In this case I'm going for a hank of linen. No matter what you are going to do with your flux, you always need to process this into hanks of linen first. There's no direct use of flex fibers and you can only process them into hanks of linen. You always you need 5 units for one hank, so out of one field you will get out of one tanning tub you will get 4 hanks of linen, which is, by the way, the average. One tub is kind of the average of what you are getting out of your fields if you are looking into the weather conditions. So the only thing you can actually look for is to plant them during morning after sunset directly, so that the first part of the growing period is during daylight. Don't plant on foggy days. You wanna have in the ideal circumstances, you have in the first growing stage, while they are this little tiny texture on the ground, you wanna have it showering. It should rain, and when they are kind of grown up, like the plants here on the field, the remaining over there behind the tanning tubs, you wanna have fair weather, so sunshine. So now I've got some hanks of linen in my inventory. I can either go to the loom, use it to make linen cloth out of the hanks of linen I've just made. I don't have enough for this, because I've stopped too early, but I don't need linen cloth at this point anyways. Linen cloth obviously is mainly used in making clothing, cloth armor, and some outfits, which I'm going to show you in a second. Okay, those outfits and armor and clothes and whatsoever, pretty much everything you can make out of cloth and out of ropes, out of cloth is made with the Reaver's rope kit, tool kit, sorry, god damn it, I'm a bit confuzzled, obviously. Okay, you open your inventory, right-click the Reaver's toolkit, go to tailoring, go to sew, and then you got all the options with stuff you can craft using the Reaver's toolkit. The first three thingies here, and it says first four, sorry, are pretty much only for decoration purposes, but use up quite a lot, resources. They don't provide any bonus or any armor whatsoever, so well, you can make yourself some decorated clothing at some point just to brag, because the amount of resources needed for this is quite hefty. After that, there are various kinds of outfits used for several professions. They all require 60 points in a in the specific skill. Blacksmith's outfit requires 60 points in forging to equip. Carpenter's 60 points in carpentry. Alchemy 60. Engineer's outfit is for the siege engineer. Cooks, yeah, obviously in cooking. They all provide some sort of bonus if you. I don't have them all in mind. Cook's outfit is like a 10% faster cooking. A blacksmith provides a skill bonus in armor smithing based on the quality of its outfit of the outfit. A quality 80 outfit will give about 50 points in armor smithing, which is quite nice. You can actually go above 100 skill points with that. So you can get way better results, or you can make, let me rephrase this and restart this. Come and now you can use lower quality resources and components to make quality 100 armor. You can use 85-ish stuff and even get the maximum quality out of this. So after that, all kinds of armors come. This is the first cloth armor padded in from the militia service skill tree, skill branch. Regular padded armor is the second, the tier one, unlocked with 30 points. Or was it 60? No, 30. I think it was 30 points in the padded armor mastery skill. Then you've got leather armor, unlocks the first thingy at zero, obviously, just after you got your 30 points in thrown weapon mastery. Next one unlocks I think regular armor should be 60 points in leather armor mastery. The third and fourth armor I haven't unlocked yet because my tailoring skill isn't high enough. It requires 90 points in tailoring for the tier 3 set, the heavy leather armor, and 100 points to craft the royal leather armor. Same goes for the padded. So the last two thingies here are pretty much inventory management items you can use to, well, organize your chests, your warehouses, and your inventory. You can fit 100 units, up to 100 units into a sack, 50 into a 50 into a bag, and I think it was 10 into a pouch. So you can use them, I don't know, to separate all kinds of preparations, herbs and whatnot. Use them for the pouch, put them in a pouch, put your seeds in a bag, and put a sack in, or several sacks in warehouses to organize items that are a bit bigger, that come in bulk. So, this about cloth. If you happen to need any ropes, you need again the Weaver's toolkit. Go to the weave rope option. Go to the linen rope. In case you got the right components in your inventory, you can now go to craft. And then you have a linen rope. It takes quite a lot of resources. It's one rope requires like 15 flex units, which is yeah, kind of like one. If it ever averages out, it's almost one flex field just for one, just to make one rope. So it's quite valuable and used on many servers as some sort of currency trading item. Besides of this use, you can of course craft some stuff out of ropes. First and foremost, the first important, really important thing you want to have in your town is the well. As mentioned earlier, it's an endless source of quality 100 water, which you need to process hides and flex fibers. And you want to have high quality, since it takes some time, you can't mass, or it's hard to mass produce them. So you want to have high quality to make decent leather armor or decent clothes armor. What else can I make out of ropes? It's mostly carpentry items. Let me check the carpenter's toolkit, which is still in the box over here. Okay, you need the carpenter's toolkit for some of those. You go to craft. Here are some of the items you can craft with the carpenter's toolkit. All of the practice weapons, which you need to grind up your the combat skills, unless you have put more than 30 points into one of the combat skills on creation, then you can start with the actual weapon. But from skill 0 to 30, you only can use the wooden practice weapon. They all require one rope. Then there is the fishing pole, which is in my opinion rather useless. It's pretty much the same thing as with the difference between iron and primitive tools. The outcome, so to say, of the tool is based on the quality. The game doesn't distinguish between primitive and iron, at least on the moment where I'm recording this video. So you might as well use the simple fishing pole, which only requires a branch and some plant fibers. What else do we got? Yeah, all the practice weapons. And that's pretty much it in this particular area. Then you need ropes for several other items. I don't have them all in mind, to be honest. You check the carpentry stuff. What can I craft here? What was it, construction? Well, let me check real quick. I always mix those thingies up. Construction. Going from stuff and things. See, plow. One of the items which I'm going to craft next, by the way. But not now. Well, this thingy also requires a rope to make. I think it was one. Well, and several other things. I don't have them all in mind. Some buildings that use cloth, like a windmill or some other stuff. Well, however, this is how you process flax after harvesting it. And yeah, basic overview of it, of the stuff you can make out of flux. In my next episode, I will take a look into all the stuff you need to cook, from the early farming recipes, how to get fed in the first 1-2 days, first few hours into the game. Go a bit into fishing, gathering stuff. Then a few short remarks on soil preparation. How much time is over? Almost 20 minutes, so I'm not gonna do this. Then What else? Fishing, gathering. Okay, then farming. What you can plant, or should plant for cooking specifically, and how to get your hands on the all the different kinds or types of meat available in game at this moment. So that's it for this episode. A bit about farming, my animal breeding disaster, and as always a blick, a view in the future. If you liked what you just saw in this episode of Life is Feudal from me, your own Oscar, please hit the like button. If you even learned something about it, hit it even more and harder. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more daily content on Life is Feudal, your own. And of course, if you got a guild or something, some sort of forum, social media access, I don't know what, share this video wherever you see it fitting in. My name is Oscar. This ends this episode. I hope to see you soon. I thank you all for watching, for subscribing, for staying in my channel, coming back, and so on. This is it. I am out for now. See ya.